Welcome to this e-learning course, Manage Returns. In this video, you will learn about the importance of managing refunds, the steps to process a refund request, issuing a refund to the customer through auto-approved returns, and by manually approving the return. Sometimes, when our customer receives the product they have ordered online, it doesn't match their expectations, or it may be damaged or defective. It may so happen that the customer no longer needs it and wants to return the product. At such instances, we as sellers are required to manage the returns and issue a refund. Let's understand the returns workflow first. When a customer raises a request for return, the seller has two options that can be configured in the account settings. The first option is to auto-approve the return request, and the second option is to manually approve each return request. Let's say that the seller has set the account settings to auto-approve return. The return is applicable only when the return request matches the Amazon return policies. In this situation, the customer will have to follow certain steps. First, the customer is required to print the return merchandise authorization and return the mailing label. Then, the customer will place the return merchandise authorization label inside the box and affix the return mailing label outside the box and send it to the seller. The customer needs to pay the fee for returning the product. After receiving the product, the seller may choose to issue a full or partial refund based on the condition of the item. The second option is to manually approve each return request received from different customers. In this situation, the seller can choose to authorize or deny the refund request. If the seller chooses to authorize the refund, the customer will have to follow the same process shown before. If the seller chooses to deny the refund request, then Amazon will send an email message to the customer with the reason for closure. Now, let us look at how you as a seller can authorize or deny the refund request on your Amazon seller account. Let's understand the steps for issuing a refund. Log in to your seller account. From the Orders menu, select Manage Returns. This is the first screen you would see in the Manage Returns page. You can narrow down the results by choosing the filters listed on the left-hand side of the page. Or you can filter the refund request received by date. When you receive a refund request, the page would display them like listed on the screen. On this page, you can choose to authorize request, close request, issue refund, or contact buyer. If you choose to authorize request, you will be directed to this page wherein you can choose to select Amazon to generate a return merchandise authorization number, or you can provide a return merchandise authorization number yourself. Confirm your return address where the customer will send the product back to you. You can then click Authorize Request at the bottom of the page, and you would see the message Return Authorization Successful, indicating that you have authorized the return. If you choose to close the refund request, you will have to select a reason and specify an optional message to buyer if you want to, and click Close Request. The third option available to you is to issue a refund. You can either choose to issue a full refund or partial refund. You will have to then fill the required fields, and you can also offer a concession to the customer by filling up the fields Return Shipping Concession or Other Concession and click Submit Refund. This can be used also as a goodwill gesture. The last option available to you is to contact the buyer using the Contact Buyer option. Here, you will have to choose the subject and then type the message you want to send to the buyer. You can also choose to add an image or file that you want to send to the buyer and then click Send Email. This brings us to the end of the process. In this course, you learned about the importance of managing refunds, the steps to process a refund request, issuing a refund to the customer by auto-approved returns, and manually approve the return.